Erstes Halbfinale der German Darts Open 2019. Er möchte jetzt mit diesem Sieg in sein viertes European Tour Finale einziehen. Die aktuelle Nummer 2 der Welt, der Weltmeister von 2018, Voltage Rob Cross. Die 2 gegen die 12 der Welt. Auch er hat schon 10 PDC-Titel in seiner Laufbahn einfahren können. Unter anderem einen European Tour-Erfolg im vergangenen Jahr. Aus Stoke-on-Trent, Ian Diamond White.
And I started quickly. Yes, I did. To just go down and check out the show.
Semi-finals time. We have the world number one, the world number two, a five-time major finalist, and one of the most prolific winners of PDC ranking titles in the sport. We start with the world number two and former world champion, Voltage Rob Cross, against the prolific title collector that is the Diamond Ian White. A man who has 10 ranking titles to his name, including one of these European Tour titles. That is something that Voltage does not have. He is looking to put that right. He's already made a Euro Tour final this year, beaten by MVG. He's made Euro Tour finals in the past, and it's that man again who's done for him. Ian White loves this tournament. He's made the semi-finals every time it's been staged. 3 times in a row now, but he has not gone on to make the final. Does that change here at the Saarlandhalle in Saarbrücken tonight, right now, as the Diamond, the number 2 seed, takes on the number 6 seed, Rob Cross? Chris Murphy in the box for it.
Yeah, well, it'll be interesting to see which of this pair goes through to have their chance of winning a first title of the year. Cross and White have met 8 times previously. Cross has actually won the last 4 meetings between the pair.
Mm.
And the one before that, where White still had a better record, was in a final of a Pro Tour back in 2017 when nobody knew who this Rob Cross fella really was.
Didn't take long for that to change.
59.
Yeah, Rob Cross has averaged over 100 in all 3 of his matches so far this weekend. You anticipate him breaking that ton mark again in this one. Ian White has 59. Been a little bit more varied, which is odd because he's usually just very consistent. But as good as he was against Jeffrey Desvan, Darren Webster this afternoon was not a great display, and Adrian Lewis had its moments and he dragged his average up to 96, but he looked vulnerable at times in that one.
Yeah, well, all 4 quarterfinals going the distance. Very different matches though for 6-5s, weren't they?
Yeah, completely. Well, that's it. Rob Cross and Gerwyn Price. Yes, Rob Cross could have been beaten, but it wasn't for the fact that Rob Cross did anything wrong. He was excellent all the way through. Ian White kind of offered up a few opportunities to Adrian 100. Lewis, and he nearly paid the price. But these two are the only two who came through without surviving match darts, unlike Dave Chisholm and Michael van Gerwen.
Yeah, neither winning titles this year, but the best 2 players to have not won titles, going by the statistics. And Rob Cross has been in four semi-finals before this one, winning two, losing two. The last one on the Euro Tour, 7-1 to Michael van Gerwen. Of course, won one at the UK Open, but was beaten by the man who van Gerwen's just beaten when he got to the final. Evan Aspinall, who put in an incredible display. One itchy there from Cross, just asked a little question. That was almost in the 51 from White, who has to try and find double 10 to deny Cross a shot at this 109, which he has done.
Well, a solid-ish 15 data for me in White, who didn't seem particularly happy with it.
Yeah, Ian White has lost a couple of semi-finals this year as well to Johnny Clayton and James Wade. He's 1-1. That was against Chris Dobie. Also losing to MVG when he got to the tournament decider. All of those on the floor for Ian White, where he does generally produce his best stuff.
And as you say, it is on the floor that generally produces his best stuff. And it is in floor tournaments the only places that he has beaten Rob Cross. Rob actually said after his win against Gerwin Price that he seems to play better on the stage. He enjoys it. Now, the stats seem to suggest it's pretty much the same. Whatever, you know, he's got Rob Cross on the moon and he's still average 102. But he did beat him at the Masters. He did beat him at the German Darts Grand Prix a couple of years back, and he beat him at the World Match Play. So when you put these guys on big stages, Rob Cross prevails. That's what's 100. Happened so far. But of course, since their last meeting on stage, the Masters, at the start of last year, Ian White has learned how to win a title on the big stage. 100. Does that make this different? Does it make it different that it's here in Saarbrücken where he's got an incredible record?
White leaves himself on a finish just in case. Cross can't complete this one. Have to go 54 for the ball. Can't find it. So Ian White has the chance to 56. Produce some fireworks.
107. Well, that'll do.
68. Yeah, not certain this, but much easier now, having found the treble with the first dart. Rob Cross gets two, now down to double two.
On the second and leg, in it. Rob Cross. Third leg in to throw first. Game on.
Well, first to seven, remember, in the semi-finals. Extended format in the semis in the final. First to seven here, first to eight in the final.
33.
Yeah, well, that has been extended across the whole Pro Tour for this season. So it'll be a format that Ian White is used to playing.
99.
When you get to the latter stages.
Ian did say that it was hard for him to play Adrian Lewis, a person he's known for years and years, since he was a teenager, and they're good mates, practice partners. Now he can unleash against the rest of the field.
Yeah, it hurts Rob Cross, doesn't it?
Absolutely. Yeah, that was the inference, wasn't it? Oh, I can't wait to rip his head off. I hate him.
I was inflicting some punishment there.
Cross needs the lot to leave a finish. Not going to get it. So Ian White looking pretty comfortable in this leg.
10th match 100. Of the weekend for Ian White. And now his favourite double.
On the third leg.
Nicely Ian done. White.
Nothing wrong with an 11 darter from the diamond.
Game on.
Well, 60-60, bend over, pick up your other dart, quick wipe of the hand.
140.
Not quite the maximum he was after. It's going to be very, very difficult to separate these two. They are both right up there in their levels of consistency over the course of this year.
Well, they have now both fired in 10 maximums in this tournament.
140.
And White has just produced an 11 dart leg. Rob Cross could do something similar.
134.
I'm not sure there are many better counters, if any, than Rob Cross out there. Because of his willingness or unwillingness to use certain parts of the board, he'll try and limit it to 20s, 19s and 18s. He has to know how best to utilise them, and he goes routes that other players wouldn't.
He's on the full flag, Rob Cross.
But whatever route he goes, he can find world-class stuff, and these two have just traded 11 dart legs. This continues. They could push each other along to do something special here.
Yeah, high-voltage darts from Rob Cross and Ian White, producing sparkling stuff as well early on. And who knows, it still has that feeling that it's just simmering away.
Mm. Well, it took 100 average to stop Ian White here 2 years ago from Benito van der Pass. It took 107 average to stop him last year from Michael Smith. And Rob Cross, we know, is quite capable. Well, actually, it's not that he's capable. We're expecting him to throw 100. It's just how big a 100 average that he puts in. Because he looks in the mood and he looks fresh.
Well, it's about 103 now. And rising. Still behind Ian White in that department, but early on in this match, well, White, another one, would leave him on a finish.
180.
All of a sudden, gives himself a real chance. But it just doesn't stop when Rob Cross is in this kind of mood. As Joe Cullen put it, you're waiting for him to have a bad visit and they just don't happen.
Well, the thing is, it did give Ian White a chance, but a little red dot on the screen tells you that this is his leg.
17.
And that's pressure. That's pressure telling, because he forces you to be as excellent as he is visit after visit after visit. And this could be a third 11 dart leg in a row in this leg, in this match. And that is exactly what we've got. Two of them to voltage and the first break of throw in the match.
Look at that. Incredible stuff, isn't it? An incredible level. Rob Cross does not play at the explosive pace that some of his rivals do, but the darts that he produces are often out of this world.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And this is just normal for him. We're not seeing him, you know, launching himself around the stage celebrating. It's not really part of his game. Yes, we saw bits of it at the World Championship, particularly in big moments, in big games. But he expects 60. This level of himself. And that's 75% on doubles. Like, he can go through spells in matches where he just does not miss the doubles. And that really does see the average shoot up.
And because he plays so much darts and 100. The tour never ends, really, and there is a continuous darting season, as we've discussed over the course of this weekend, it's everyone becomes familiar, especially when they get into the business end of many of the tournaments. It's easy to forget that Rob Cross
59.
Did the rags-to-riches sporting story when he was catapulted from relative obscurity to become world champion in his first professional season. And I think for a man that's done that, he's done very, very well to keep his feet on the ground and just carry on concentrating on the darts.
Oh, I'm
he's been very sensible with, you know, he's bought a house, he's got a lovely place down in Sussex, and he's got, you know, he's got the swimming pool and stuff like that. But he's a very family orientated man, and he is quite a grounded individual. But I mean, I'm baffled as to the people who they talk about last year as if it was dreadful.
Yeah.
Now, he didn't win as many titles as he did in his first year, but at the same time, he still picked up titles, and he still beat MVG in a televised final.
What's White thinking here? 63 scored. Lose one.
69.
They left 182. Opted for the bullseye. Could have gone 18s, couldn't he?
58.
And left himself on a big out. But he decided to try and leave something big, but just not as big, and in the end didn't leave a finish at all.
He leaves himself 76 here. Now, various options for this. He won't be a player that goes treble 17 here. Should be the 18th segment.
If he can start on treble 18 in any combination, he will.
94.
It's as if he feels that's the most likely treble that he's going to hit.
Beautiful dart, leaves double 8. And Ian White breaks straight back. It's not an 11 darter, but it's a break of throw. And that's what counts. Three all in this one. You cannot separate them. We have seen some close games between them when they first met on a big stage. It was the World Match Play. And Voltage, on his debut of the tournament, won that one by 10 legs to 7. When they last met in that Pro Tour final last summer, he won it by 6 legs to 4. He has won a last leg decider. That was one of his first titles. But Ian White has won a couple of 6-4 games himself.
Reminder that the other semi-final features Michael Van Gerwen and Dave Chisnell. And both of those have produced some, well, Van Gerwen won really big, well, both won really big performance, to be fair. Van Gerwen was made to work harder to win with his 107 average, and Chisnell was to win with his 106 this afternoon against Peter Wright.
Well, we've very nearly seen Michael Van Gerwen go out of the tournament with 107 average.
Yeah, he was also taken to a last leg decider by Barney this afternoon. Hard work, hard day at the office for MVG, but he's still in it. And just when it looked like White was about to hit the front again, Rob Cross lands a maximum to leave another potential 11 dart leg.
Well, these four visit legs, they are so vital. They change the course of the game. Sometimes you need them, particularly when Ian White is leaving things like 80 after four visits. You're going to break the throw, you need it. And he needs the ball.
Just the wrong side of the ring. But much like playing Michael Van Gerwen matches against Rob Cross, these kind of finishers, you know, you need to hit. White misses. He won't come back, will he?
He will, but it may be the next leg.
Rob Cross moving across. He's not quite sure how far to go, which I think he's ended
exactly
up back
where
he started. Yeah.
With a similar result.
Well, White does come back in this leg. Is it his leg?
It is, and Ian White moves into the lead. 3-2 down, now 4-3 up.
You know, White won that European Tour title last year. Let's not forget that Rob Cross still needs one to complete his set.
Yeah, he's got the World Series title as well to add to his collection. 77. Something upon which Ian White has not yet featured.
Of course, has played in three finals on the Euro Tour, lost them all to Michael van Gerwen. Could end up meeting MVG again tonight, and I said it earlier, but it's quite literally becoming a weekly meeting between the pair, isn't it?
Well, yeah. Sometimes bi-weekly.
What do you put Ian White's
59
performance down to last weekend? Just a bad day at the office, or was he,
I think it has to be honest,
daydreaming about Easter eggs?
Well, I mean, maybe, bearing in mind that Ian White may be ostensibly a 48-year-old man, but really, he's a gigantic toddler. But he's a gigantic toddler who might be about to go 85. Two legs clear of the world number two in the semi-finals of the German Darts Open, because he's got two visits from 1-2-1. And the way they're playing, this should just be a gimme in two visits.
64.
He's left himself a simple two darter. Rob Cross was miles off of the first dart. Was that a
100.
An attempt at a showboating 140 there?
Double top. Not a great guide, but he manages to find double top anyway.
Yeah, I think it was a good line for him to follow. He couldn't really use the dart,
no,
could he?
There's plenty of room to cram it underneath that dart and still above the double top. You sometimes feel that Rob Cross, no matter where he puts it, he can find space. I've never seen, there are very few players who can do what Rob Cross does, which seems to stick things on the bottom wire and still jam darts underneath to get into a treble 20 like this. I mean, you could shove them under there.
I think he's that good that Rob Cross often blocks himself on doubles, because when he misses, it is so close.
Mm. I think we saw that on the double eight earlier on, didn't we? And ultimately, it hurt him. Is Ian White finally going to get over the line in the German Darts Open and make the final? Semi-final disappointments the last 2 years.
139.
Well, look, we're not going to write off Dave Chisnell at all, but Michael van Gerwen does usually hand out a bit of a beating to Dave Chisnell when they meet.
I mean, you could have just left it there. We're not going to write off Dave Chisnell, but Michael van Gerwen usually does.
Yeah,
when
that's
he
true.
Goes up against him.
50, and often Dave Chisnell does himself.
Well, yeah, you get that impression sometimes.
But I'm going to ask you a little question here, Dan. Who would you have down as the most likely man to beat Michael van Gerwen should it be the green machine that gets to the final?
Well, if you're going to go on who is playing the better darts this year and who is in the most likely position to throw a higher standard of dart to beat Michael van Gerwen, then you say it is Rob Cross. Ian White's not far behind, and he's playing better than him in this match right now. But I believe that context matters. And Rob Cross has suffered a series of very big defeats to Michael van Gerwen very recently. And Ian White has beaten MVG in this hall on this stage 2 years running. And double seven. Oh my, that is not where you can miss that.
Yeah, it would have been to move to the brink. And now Rob Cross can peg him back and break the throw. And then would throw to restore parity at five apiece.
John 14 data. This semi-final is still very much alive. And after four quarter-finals that all went to last leg deciders, the semi-finals are following suit at the moment. Because here comes Voltage with a 177.
It is certainly looking like Cross is set to level up. The smallest opportunity. Those two darts missed by Ian White, and Rob Cross has just helped himself, hasn't he, since then?
Well, the best players, the really top players, they can go on bursts. They can go on bursts where it's very difficult to stop them. You have to find 11 or 12 darters to do it.
99.
Michael van Gerwen does it to people all the time. Gary Anderson does it. Phil Taylor used to do it. Rob Cross is a player who can do it. He's done it to Michael van Gerwen.
Yeah, when Cross was looking for a nickname, I was a big fan of the relentless shout that someone made. I think Ryan Joyce has that now, but it certainly fits Rob Cross, doesn't it? Because he certainly is that.
It's a bullseye again for Voltage.
He was close last time.
60.
And he might have just given Ian White at least a poke at the ball. That's all he's going to get. Has to find the treble 17 first. Can't do it.
Because it might be one of those situations where you need a 12 darter to stop him. And Ian White couldn't produce the 12 darter in this leg. And it means that Rob Cross should get a couple of darts to level this match. A match that he very nearly went 6-3 down in.
Double eight. Oh, it was in, then it was out. Rob Cross can't believe it.
I'm not sure Ian White can believe.
I'm not sure Ian White was looking at the time. I think he's kind of wondering what kind of thing has happened. Well, you can see that the mark...
It's gone in. He's nowhere near a wire. Absolutely nowhere near a wire. What has him gone on? What's he made out of?
Well,
rubber?
Right then.
Don't aim for that bit. That bit will do.
Insult to injury. Salt in the wound. And I'm not sure we've often seen Rob Cross, but that might have angered him a little because he threw the dart perfectly and it just was rejected.
Well, sometimes the fates decide what is going to happen, and the fates have determined that the Saarlandhalle will be a place where Ian White enjoys enormous success.
Respect to Rob Cross,
absolutely,
for that response.
It should be noted that, you know, Rob Cross, he had an incredible run here last year, and he was only beaten in a last leg decider by the eventual champion, Max Hopp. He was averaging pretty much 100 all the way through the tournament, and averaged 99 in the semi-final, and was only pipped by the 100 average of Max Hopp, and here he goes with five perfect darts, and that'll be six. And having seen the board rudely reject a perfectly thrown winning double, he has responded in the absolute perfect way.
40.
We had a perfect leg way back when on Friday afternoon. That came from Steve Beaton. Rob Cross can't follow suit.
41.
Tidied it up well.
But couple of trebles for the diamond. And there's one.
100.
Well, there's still a chance here for Ian White to sew this up.
Well, there is, but there's certainly life in this match if Rob Cross takes this out, and he's got two darts at tops. Double 10, and he lives on. Another break.
Are we going all the way?
Well, it should have been 5-5, shouldn't it? Will it be 6-6?
55.
Absolutely absorbing contest. Both men averaging round about that ton mark. There you see it.
83.
Look at those number of two treble visits from Ian White. And I'm making up for the fact that Rob Cross is dominating on the 180s. First nine average, you can barely get anything 96. Between them. But he's so tight as you would expect from two of the best players in the world.
Two more of them to come.
So
we are within minutes of finding out which of this pair will be the first to the final of the German Darts Open. It has been a remarkable tournament. We've seen all sorts this weekend. Thrills, spills, fun, drama. We've seen glorious defeats. But it looks like this evening's session is going to be
83.
About dramatic deciders. Rob Cross could be a couple of visits away from forcing another one.
That isn't great. This could be. This really could be.
140.
Whose shoes would you rather be in right now?
158 with the darts in hand, or 102 and waiting? Well, this would be enormous.
120.
Now, White could have utilised the ball, couldn't he, last visit, and had a two darter here.
He could have done. Could go bullseye here. Stayed. He thought he had the line. He didn't have the weight, 50. And he does not get a shot for the leg. Rob Cross.
Does he go back where he's just missed, or does he split?
I genuinely don't know. I think he's going at it. He is. Oh, my. Oh,
22.
My. Well, surely. This is the moment for Ian White. Oh my. Well, he's looked nerveless throughout this game. He's gone for a little wander. He's going to try and laugh it off. I think it's probably a good tactic. We saw him nearly collapse in his Karol Sedlacek game last weekend. That was because he couldn't stop missing doubles. Now, it's because he's accidentally hit one. Can he hit double six on purpose? He can, and he does. And Ian White, after semi-final disappointment for the last 2 years at the German Darts Open, is through to the final. Nobody has a better record in this venue than the Diamond. And if he can win one more game, he will pick up a second Euro Tour title. He'll take on either Chizzy or Van Gerwen. That semi-final is coming up as the Diamond books his place in tonight's climax.
Ian White ist der erste Finalist von Saarbrücken. Applaus für Voltage Rob Cross. Und Ian White zieht hier tatsächlich in das Finale ein. Es gibt die Absprache mit der PDC, nach den Halbfinals keine Interviews zu führen, sodass sich die Spieler auf die Abend auch wunderbar vorbereiten können.